Hello everyone, my name is Samiksha and I will be creating these beautiful flowers with pencil colors. Initially, I simplified the type of flowers and leaves I'm going to draw with simple pencil strokes. I'll go over these strokes again to draw some curved lines and form the outline of the flowers and leaves. Doodling should be a calming experience and not a worry to draw perfect flowers. That's why I tried to keep the process as simple as possible. Then I created a color palette which I wanted to use here. I am using a Faber-Castell color pencils with 24 shades. It is always advisable to test your colors because some color might appear different after you blend them with a damp brush. I'm using yellows and orange for this one. You can use whatever color you want. Some pinks and purples will also look very beautiful in this. I have already made a layout of where I want to place the flowers and the leaves to save us some time. Now, starting with the center of the flower, I made some circular shaped pieces close to each other and filled half of the center with it. For the other half, I made the same thing but in denser form to create an illusion that the tiny circles are getting smaller and smaller as we reach the top. I started tracing petals around the center. Try to create some folded and curved petals to give it more natural look. I made some curves suggesting petals on the other side of the flower as they are not visible from the side view that we are drawing. And I made some more flowers with the same process and made some overlapping petals as well. For the stem, I made two lines first and then went over with a third one very close to any one of the lines to add some 3D effect. These lines are not perfect and they did not turn out the way I wanted it, but it works. Then I made the bud same way I created the center of the flower. The transition between the denser and the lighter part was too abrupt for my liking, so I decided to fade it a little bit. Now, if you ask me what did I just draw with this weird shapes, I don't know. They look pretty with the flowers, so I thought I should add them. I'm done with all the flowers and the buds now, so I started adding small leaves here and there. I also took this chance to fill up the empty spaces with some more small leaves. I wanted all the larger leaves to be at the bottom. I made them curvy and folded to add a little statement to the work. I made some of them long, some of them wavy, some of them behind the stem or whatever I could think of at that moment. Now I was almost done with the main outline of the drawing. I went over the flowers to make some dotted dashed lines. I started the lines from the center of the flowers along the boundary of the petals. We don't have to draw the lines all over the body of the leaves. Also, try to make them in different shapes and lengths, maybe along the boundary or along the edges. For the veins of the leaves, I use the same dash dotted lines to draw them. Now that is it for the drawing part. This is already looking so beautiful even without coloring it. Unfortunately, the camera stopped recording when I did those two flowers above. I used three colors here. First, I took the medium yellow to color all the petals. Then I colored along the boundary of only one side of the petal with a brighter yellow and the other side with orange. If you want the flower to look yellow, don't use too much orange because the orange will dominate over the yellow after adding water to it. You can use different ratios of yellows and oranges to different petals or even flowers to make them coordinate with each other because all the flowers don't have to look exactly the same, right? Then use a fairly damp brush to run over those colors. Don't add too much water to the brush or it will take away some of the pigment with it. I wanted the buds to have a warmer tone to it than the center of the flower, as they are not fully grown yet. I used a brown color for the center of the flower and a reddish brown for the buds. While using pencil colors, try creating soft lines with them by applying minimum pressure to the paper. If you want some deeper color, go over it again with the same color once you are done with the first layer. If you apply more pressure to the page, you will get harsh lines which is very difficult to blend together even after going over it with a wet brush. Better way is to keep building layers and keep mixing different colors in those layers. I used dark green color for the leaves because I wanted to contrast them against that yellow, but the dark green color was of a very cool tone. So I went over the two layers of the dark green with a shading of a light green color along the boundary of one side of the leaf like we did for the petals, and then blended them out with a damp brush. I already used the darkest green for the leaves, and now I wanted the stems to be of a more deeper color. So I used brown and green together. The stem was already very thin, so I didn't go for the details here. If the pencil colors are blended properly, it exactly looks like a watercolor painting. And our little masterpiece is ready now.